Hey everyone, and welcome back to today's video. I'm going to show you how to create a Facebook business page for your Facebook account. Now, I know some of you are thinking, why do we need a Facebook business page? Because like literally, isn't Facebook a bit dead by now? No, it's not. Facebook has nearly 3 billion monthly active users and is the third most visited website on the web after Google and YouTube. And it puts it ahead of leading social media platforms such as Twitter and Instagram. So Facebook is definitely not being used. And with 2.96 million active users on a monthly basis, you just can't ignore this beast. And the tools within Facebook are absolutely amazing. So you do definitely need to have a Facebook business page. And if you want to learn the newest strategies around how to use Facebook in 2023, then I've dropped a link to a video that I've just released on my channel, and you'll be able to watch that as well. And that will go really well with this video. Okay, so let's just jump straight into Facebook, and I'm going to show you exactly how to make a new Facebook business page. Okay, so here we are in Facebook. So of course, log into Facebook and you will always come to your personal profile. So that's you as a person. Now, in order for you to build a Facebook page, you do need to have a personal profile, and your personal profile will look like this. It will have a picture of something on the top, it will have your name, and it will be your friends. So this is a personal profile. If you're not sure about the different profiles, then check out that video I mentioned earlier. Now, in order for you to create a Facebook page, what you can do is come up here to these 9 square dots, or these 9 dots, and down here it says create a page. So go ahead and click that. Now that's going to open up this great little big window, and we're going to go through how to do this with you. Okay, so now we're here, it says create page. So the first thing you need to do is create your page with a name. So this is either going to be your personal name if you're a personal brand, or if you are a business or a more of a focused brand, then it can be your brand name. Now for me, I'm going to be creating one under a new brand that I'm creating called Nutrition Uncovered. So just pop in the name of that page on your inside there. Okay, so you do have to add a category. So I'm just going to put health and wellness in here because that's what I'm building this around. You can, of course, type in the first couple of letters of the category you think your company or your business or your brand falls into, and then it will give you some recommendations. I will just note that I am in Great Britain and it is quite US specific. So if you can't find anything in your own language, look for an alternative in the US English language, and that hopefully will come up. You can add your bio. Now this is optional. What I would suggest you do is go through the creation of your page and then add your bio in later. But when you start typing, it doesn't seem that there's much of a limit, but I would say that your bio should be around 200 words long. Then all you have to do is click create page. Now it says down the bottom there, Nutrition Uncovered has been created. So now you need to finish off your page. So what you can do is you can add your website in here. So if you don't have a website, you can leave this blank. If you do have a website, drop it in there. I'm just going to add my normal website for the moment. If you want to put your phone number in here, you can. If you don't, then you don't have to. It's entirely up to you. If you don't want to put your phone number in there, leave it blank. If you do, then you can. You need to realise that that phone number is going to be public. You can change it on your page to not show, but it still will be there inside of Facebook. So you have to decide whether you want to put that phone number in there or not. One alternative is to add the WhatsApp option onto your page, and therefore you'll take people to your WhatsApp business number. Location is really important if you are a bricks and mortar company. So if you are a bricks and mortar company, then location is super, it will be really, really good for you to put location down, because it's going to pull people to where you're based. And if you are a one location of a bigger brand, then of course make sure it's very narrowed down to your exact location. If you are one location for a global brand, then you could just put maybe your head office or something like that. I'm just going to put London in here as the town for the time being, and I'm just going to leave the rest blank. Another thing it does here is your hours. So if you aren't like online only, if you are in person, so in other words, somebody has to come to your shop to buy products as well as being online, you can have your hours of work open. So you can have no hours are available, always open or open on select hours. So you can decide whether you want to do that. Click the next button and you'll go to the next bit. So customize your page. This is really important. Your profile picture is the picture of you if you are a personal brand, or it could be your logo, or it could be a business logo. So it's either going to be a photo of you as a personal brand, or it's going to be your logo if you have a logo or if you are a business. So don't forget that you can create this profile picture in Canva. So go ahead and do that and then download it to your computer and click on your computer and bring that logo in. And you can again do the cover photo in Canva. Go ahead and design it in Canva. Make sure you add in your name, your brand, and some pictures and things like that. Save it to your computer, click add photo, cover photo, grab that from your computer, click open, and that will pop that in there as well. The next thing is really important, and that's this add action button. Now, most people just think that the add action button is follow my page or message, but actually when you click on it, there are quite a lot of different actions, and this is super important. And this is going to be the difference between you getting a lead or somebody not knowing how to contact you. So click try it. And as you can see, there are quite a lot of different options. And most people just skip this thinking, oh no, it'll be fine. But actually they miss out on so much. So you can have book now. So you can connect it to a booking system. You can have sign up so they could go to your website and maybe download a free lead magnet or sign up for a free trial. They can have an order. So if you're a restaurant or you're a takeaway business, you can get people to book orders through here. If you've got products, you can have a shop set up inside of Facebook. And of course, you can link them to your shop. If you're selling products or tickets or events, then you can get tickets. You can get people to contact you. So if you want to use Facebook as a lead generation, you can get people to send you messages. You can send WhatsApp messages, call now, send emails, contact us. And if you have a group on Facebook, so this is important if you are growing a community, you can even have people visit your group. So you decide which one of these is the most important for you. I'm going to get them to go to my website for now. So I'm going to send them to my website and I'm going to click next. And then I'm going to put my website link in there. And then I'm going to save that. Okay, so then go to next. Then it's going to ask you to connect WhatsApp to your page. So if you want to do this, this is all important, especially if you want to use WhatsApp as a tool, then go ahead and do that. All you need to do is add your phone number and your WhatsApp number. I'm not going to do that right now. I'm just going to skip through that for the time being. And of course, you don't have to do everything right now. You can do this over a course of a few days if you're just setting your page up. Go ahead and click skip. Okay, so the next bit here is build your page audience, and Facebook is going to give you the option to invite your friends. Now, I just want to quickly talk to you about this in a little bit more depth. If you invite your friends to like your Facebook business page without actually posting anything on your page relevant to what your business is about, you may skewer the Facebook algorithm. Now, what I mean by that is that if you suddenly get an influx of people liking your page, but then they don't go on to interact with your content, you may be misleading the Facebook algorithm and you may be damaging your chances right from the start. So I would suggest that when Facebook asks you to invite friends to your Facebook page, when you're setting your page up like we are doing on this video, that you don't do that. What I suggest you do is you start posting regularly on your Facebook business page, the same as perhaps you do on other platforms, and build up an audience who are interested in the content that you're currently sharing. Then what you can do is you can once a week share information about your page onto your personal profile and invite those people who already know you on Facebook to go and check out what's going on your page. And if they want to follow your page and they are willing, and that's up to them, of course, to interact with your content, but if they like your content, then they're more likely to interact with it. Then they have the choice to like your page. And if you're not sure about this strategy, then have a little look at the video below this video. And I'll also link it at the end, because this goes through some of the strategies that you can be using in 2023. Okay, so I'm going to skip over invite friends and go ahead and click next. Now, of course, you do want to be notified about things happening on your page, so I'm going to keep these turned on. If you want marketing and promotional emails about your page, then that's up to you. I personally don't want emails from Meta all the time. I look at their blog and I look at their updates to find out what's going on. But of course, if you want to get some information from them, leave that on. And then if you find that it's too much, you can go ahead and switch that off later. Click done. And then your page is going to be created for you. Okay, so now we've got our page. So welcome to your new page. If you want to go through this, take a tour, you can. Let's just quickly go through it. It shows you how easy it is for you to switch between each page. It also tells you how to get to your stuff quickly. It also shows you how to explore your page feed, which is different from your personal profile feed. And then you are free to start uploading and posting to your page. Now, before you do that, I want to just make sure that you get, if possible, your page username. So this is a this is like your page's unique address. At the moment, my page, if we go to my page, if I just refresh this here, just quickly go to this page, and I'm just going to refresh it. Okay, so as you can see up here, we have facebook.com/profile PHP and then loads of numbers. What we want to do is we want to make that link to Facebook and your particular business page unique and branded to your business. So to do that, what we need to do is we need to go to our settings. And as you can see here, we can now set our username. So this is the username that when people tag you on Facebook and when you share your page, that's what's going to show up. So to change this, click the edit button. So once you click the edit button, you will be here. And as you can see, it's going to be facebook.com/ your username. So your username needs to be as close to your brand name as possible. And your username for your business page should be similar to the or the same as the username you use on other social media platforms, so that you don't get confused with other people and so that your brand starts to get embedded in people's mindset. So I'm going to put Nutrition Uncovered here. So let's just put this in here. Now it will tell us if it's available, and yes, it is. So Nutrition Uncovered is available. So then all you need to do is grab that by clicking Save Changes. It will ask you for your password. So just add your password in there. Okay, so now I've got my username. What I want to do now is go back to my page. So if I just go back up here and click on my Nutrition Uncovered, it's gone back to my page and you can see up here that all important URL, which I can share across everywhere now, will take people directly back to this page on my Facebook account. Now that we've done that, I just want to quickly show you where you can go to add any other information. So to manage your page, you click on this manage option and it's going to let you see your professional dashboard. So in here, you'll be able to see your home of your page, the content that you've put on your page, the audience of your page. You'll also be able to look at the ad center, invite friends to follow if you want to, and all of the other tools inside of Facebook at your fingertips and your disposal. So that's something that you can look into and dive into a bit later once you start posting to your page. If you want to edit your page, just click the edit button. And as you can see, you can edit your profile picture, edit the cover, and you can also add that all important bio that we didn't do at the beginning. So you can add that in here if you want. And as I can see here, it's 101 characters for your bio here. You can also customize your intro, change your links, add some hobbies, add any featured information in here. So you can come back to this by clicking on the edit option here on your page. Okay, so I hope you found this video useful. It was a quick overview of how to create a Facebook business page for your business here on Facebook. Don't forget that if you've enjoyed this video, to give it the thumbs up and do smash that subscribe button, because there are lots of things to learn about Facebook, Instagram and YouTube on my channel. My name's Anita Wong. Thank you for watching. And if you have any questions, drop them in the comments below and I'll be sure to answer them. Don't forget to watch my next videos.